Crime here in Maine has gone down overall, but the news is not all good. Good evening, and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The stats are in for 2012, and they show a sharp increase in pharmacy robberies, which skewed those numbers. But crime dropped for the year by 1.5%. Robberies were up by 14%, and last year alone, there were 56 pharmacy robberies. Also up significantly, domestic violence cases for the second year in a row, those were up 5%. News 8's Meghan Torjussen has the latest now on these numbers. Meghan?
Good evening, Tracy. The number of reported domestic violence cases is up 4.5%. Advocates say more cases equal more victims and more services. The problem? Less money.
Bubbly, energetic. She had these, like, big brown eyes.
Nicole Oliver's life was cut short by an act of domestic violence. In 2007, the 24-year-old mother of two had just left her husband when he shot and killed her. Oliver's best friend, Amanda Morris, organizes a walk every year in Oliver's memory. It raises money and awareness for domestic violence. Morris says the event helps save lives.
Introducing people to the services that are out there, I think, is huge.
Advocates say the services and awareness from events like Nicole's run may be the reason the latest numbers show a 4.5% increase in reported domestic violence cases in Maine.
If it means more victims are calling the police and trusting the system, that's a good thing. And it says something about the state of law enforcement.
And some police departments, like South Portland, have increased their outreach.
We work with Family Crisis Services. We have an advocate that actually goes with officers to do follow-up calls.
Experts say the number could also point to increased incidents of domestic violence, but they can't be sure. But Julia Culpitz with the Maine Coalition to End Domestic Violence says what is certain is that the stats show there are more victims, but less money to treat them. And the major reason? Federal budget cuts, known as the sequester.
It frankly amazes me that legislators and affluent business people can't be expected to stand a little bit longer in an airport line without the whole sequester being changed to accommodate them. And at the same time, we're expecting victims to stand in line for life-saving services.
Julia Culpitz also adds many outreach offices are facing layoffs and even closures, and now we're seeing a trend. This is the second year the number of reported cases has increased by more than 4%. In the newsroom, WMTW, Meghan Torjussen.